Hey everybody, happy holidays. It's me, Heather, and I'm here with a video to talk about the Dyson AirWrap. And what the Dyson AirWrap looks like is this. It's like a dryer. That's basically what it is. And it comes in a big old case like this. Well, I'm not sure. There's different versions of the Dyson AirWrap, and I'm not sure if they come in as big of a case or what the other cases look like. But I have the AirWrap complete. So I have all the attachments, and they are in here. Like so, and you get with the, the lighting's off. Okay, there it goes. In the complete set, you get the dryer nozzle. You get two different type of combs. I do believe this is the one that adds body you're supposed to, and I guess this one is just for straightening. I really stick to this one more, and I don't typically use this one a whole lot. Also, you get two body curlers, and what's cool about these is they will wrap theirself, like your hair will wrap on them theirself, and you get two smaller curler pieces, and you, which there's hair all over this, so that's, you get the round brush piece, which is one of my favorite pieces of the complete set. So, I figured we would talk a little bit about this and why I decided to spend the enormous price of $550, I think is what I paid for it. I would have to look on the website, and I'll put it on the screen exactly how much I paid for it. But yeah, it's really expensive. It's not a cheap product by any means. But I got to this place where I didn't even look forward to doing my hair anymore, which before, not too long ago, as you can see, I still have like the blonde growing now, and I like my hair where it's at now, but I've always had really coarse hair, and then I bleached it, and I was really bleach blonde, almost platinum blonde for close to like 5 years. I was constantly doing my hair, except I mean, we didn't touch parts that were already bleached, but it didn't matter. My hair was already coarse and really thick, and so to straighten my hair or blow dry my hair made my hair just feel horrible. I got to this place where I didn't want to do my hair at all, and so I had seen a video on Pinterest of a girl doing her hair with the Dyson AirWrap, and I was just like throwing money at it, like trying anything to do something with my hair. And I just love the way my hair gets styled with the Dyson AirWrap. I haven't touched a straightener, a regular blow dryer, anything since I've bought this product. And I don't really use a whole lot of product in my hair while styling. In the video, I do use, what I do use on a normal basis, I use this heat primer by Pantene. Sometimes I'll use a Qi heat primer that I have. But I really like that Pantene one. And I use a little leave-in conditioner, just whatever one you like. Right now I have this Garnier one. It's nothing special. And to control frizz, which the frizz does kind of fall after you get it done, after you get your hair done. It kind of gets a little frizzy, but you are like blow-drying your hair. I use these Silk Infusions by Qi. And I just love the way it styles my hair. I feel like it looks so much better than it could ever look if I were to just blow dry my hair and then try to straighten it, or fall asleep with my hair wet and let it get super curly and then try to straighten it. It just never looks good. But I love how the ends of my hair always turn out. It looks like I just went to the salon and got my hair done, in my opinion. And I'm not like completely, I've always been really bad at doing my hair. Like, I have no talent in doing my hair. And as you will see, because I'm going to speed through throughout the process, I only use a couple of pieces out of here. I'll show you what I'm going to use. I use this brush first, like, to go through it and mostly dry it all the way. I start from when my hair is pretty damp to almost dry. And I'll do this, like, piece first and, like, go through my hair and kind of dry it. Then I use the round brush, and I use it to kind of flip the ends out. And you can go underneath it if you wanted to add body, but I feel like this piece, the little brush piece, adds enough of that. And I don't have to do that, so I just use this to kind of flip the ends out. And then at the end, when I get towards the, like, front of my hair, like just these pieces. I'll use these and kind of help flip it out even more, and all these other little pieces around to add a little extra flair to it. The other pieces, like I said, I don't use too often. I use the hair dryer piece every now and then if my hair's too wet and I really want to style it. I'll kind of get to that damp spot where I like to style it. But yeah, we'll just get right into it and I'll show you how I style it. I don't do anything special and it still looks amazing. Okay, so what I'm starting off with is the Pantene Heat Primer. I've already sprayed my hair with this, that way I didn't have to spray it around my camera or anything. And I also used the Garnier Fructis leave-in conditioner, nothing too special. And so here's the dryer piece. And I always like to start out with the, I got hair stuck in this, oops. I still got hair stuck in it. Ew. Anyways, I like to start out with this brush. It has two different brushes. This is the other brush that comes with it. And I do believe the one with the little round pink ends is the one they say that's used for volume. I will have to check. I have the guide somewhere. But when I do my hair, if my hair is already just towards the drier side, like I like to start out, then I don't need to use the little dryer piece. This is the regular hair dryer piece. But if it's too wet, I'll use that. But typically what I use when I do my hair is this brush piece, and I switch back and forth between that and the round brush. I love this piece. It's probably my favorite piece. And the body curlers. So that's these two, right? And it does come with two little curlers. I don't really use these too much. I haven't played with them too much either. And I typically don't use this one. So there's that information for you if you want to know exactly what I use out of the box. So I kind of will probably speed up some of this because all you will hear is the dryer going and everything. So that's not going to be super fun to listen to the entire time. So I'll probably speed it up and put some music over it and come back in if I need to talk you through something. But like I said, I pretty much switch between these two, so if you see me switching, that's what I'm doing. All right, and hold on, let me get, oops, sorry about that, I had to get my hairbrush real fast. I'm gonna brush through it real quick just to make sure there's no tangles. That'll make it easier. Oops.
It's Christmas Day, I'm alone again. She's with him now, I'm with my loneliness. She ran away 4 months ago, left with his sleigh for the North Pole. Please come back home and leave that fat man alone. Santa, you bitch, didn't get a damn thing my Christmas list. All I got was this broken heart, and that's it. Santa, you bitch, oh, there's only one thing that I truly wish. I wish my old girl would have never kissed Saint Nick. Would have never kissed Saint Nick. I saw him dancing under mistletoe. Thought it was nothing, but I guess I didn't know that there was something going on with them. Santa, you player, I thought we were friends. Please come back home and leave that fat man alone. Santa, you bitch, didn't get a damn thing from my Christmas list. All I got was this broken heart, and that's it. Santa, you bitch, oh, there's only one thing that I truly wish. I wish my old girl would have never kissed Saint Nick. Would have never kissed Saint Nick. Oh, Santa, you bitch, didn't get a damn thing from my Christmas list. All I got was this broken heart, and that's it. Santa, you bitch, oh, there's only one thing that I truly wish. I wish my old girl would have never kissed. Santa, you bitch, didn't get a damn thing from my Christmas list. All I got was this broken heart, and that's it. Santa, you bitch, oh, there's only one thing that I truly wish. I wish my old girl would have never kissed Saint Nick.
So that's really all I do to style my hair. I don't do anything really special. I usually finish it off with some, what is it? I think it's Big and Sexy, or I don't know, whatever. Hairspray, sometimes just a suave hairspray, whatever. I think you do have to consider humidity wherever you live. If I walk outside and it's raining or it's humid, it's not going to hold this style. So get you some products that help hold your hair for humidity. But I think that the Dyson Airwrap is worth every penny. Of course, it's extremely expensive, but for me, I just wouldn't want to style my hair any other way. This is my go-to hairstyle, and I love it, and I feel like it just looks way better than if I just straightened it or tried to curl it or do anything like that to it. So I'm happy with it. It doesn't take a lot of effort to get a good hairstyle with it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a happy holidays, and I'll see you later. Bye.